Holy crap, welcome back. This is Hyperspeed, the show where I try to speed or maze games while drinking Red Bull, or in this case, energy drinks. I'm gonna have to change that slogan because I don't drink Red Bull anymore. Instead, we have Bing Energy Juice, which is equally as good. This is gonna be the throwback episode, so it's gonna be a blast from the past. As you'll notice, I am in my classic, I don't give a fuck hat. So, there's that. And also, this is a very old series. And also, I'm gonna be drinking something I haven't had in a while. And also, this thing is expired like a month ago, so even that's a throwback. I mean, come on. And Justin has my good, webcam, so we are also using the crappy old webcam. So, man, it's just a blast from the past in every direction. Actually, that's not the crappy old webcam, because this is a new computer, but it's still not as good as the Logitech one. Anyway, today on Hyperspeed, I'm going to be doing something a little bit special. You may have noticed, in episode, I want to say it's 4, there was a level back in hell that I skipped because it was impossible for me to beat because of my controller glitch and the platforms just bugging the fuck out. But I can't feel too good about that. I don't feel too good about skipping that level. So I'm gonna crack open this right here, this red can for the red that I'm gonna be seeing. Because I'm back in hell. Return to hell. This is my journey back. Crack it open, take a sip, and we're gonna follow the old rules of Hyperspeed, which is a sip for every death, which is gonna be absolute insanity, considering this is Super Meat Boy. And let's just make sure my controller is not glitching. It's not. I'm good. Okay, so we're gonna try and do this on the first try, and if we can, then this episode will contain the rest of, shit, where did I leave off? I think the next level was the end, and I just never finished the end. That's funny. I'm pretty sure I finished Rapture. I'll have to check that later. Fact check that. So, yeah, yeah, I just figured I'd kill myself there. Let me just... I deserve that one. I also deserve another one. For what's about to happen, following the old rules, because I have to go right off the start on this one, I will kill myself after... I'll kill myself when I don't get the timing right, and that won't count as a sip. You'll understand what I mean when I get there. Alright, so here we go. Here we go. Alright, well, thankfully, the platform is actually working this time, which is a nice change from when it usually doesn't. It's not killing me on its own, which is a really nice... That's a really nice little thing. Really nice little feature that we got there. Motherfucker. Sorry, I've been a lot less censored recently. So what I meant earlier when I said, when I kill myself it doesn't count, that's what I was referring to. I killed myself there because, thanks to me having to take a sip, motherfucker. Great start, guys! Here we go! Woo! Anyway, thanks to me having to take a sip, it screwed up my timing, so it doesn't count as a death. Anything else, though, will count as a death. Motherfucker, that counts. Anything I do out of sheer stupidity, I should really clean up that mess. Excuse me. So naturally, 3 seconds in, I managed to already spill something, so this is gonna go great. Clearly my hand-eye coordination is going real well today. So I'm just gonna keep that rag right there with me, just in case. Just in case I, per se, piss myself in anger, or, throw up from stress. Or, you know, in case I gut myself right here in this video, out of, self-hatred, self-loathing, at least my blood will be easier to clean up because there will be a rag right on hand. No problem, right? No problem, guys. So, it's been a while since I played Super Meat Boy. In fact, since I got this new computer, I haven't touched it. I installed it a while ago. Planning to do some more episodes of this, but I never did. Thanks to, I don't know what I'm saying. Thanks to something, right? Just, busyness, I guess. And, oh well. And so I haven't played it since, so I'm a little bit rusty. And also, I'm playing it on a TV with the slightest visual lag. Not enough to really be noticeable, but enough that it bugs you when you're holding the controller, when you're the one playing. It is very annoying. Well, that's technically the farthest I've gotten yet, so I mean, that's a plus, right? Motherfucker. See, I can't blame the controller glitch or the platforms anymore because I have a new computer and a new setup. That doesn't count, by the way. I needed to move my mic. I had a new controller and a new setup, and everything works fine now. God damn it. I think there is some visual lag, but, who knows? We'll see if that's actually having any real effect. Right now, it seems I'm too busy being an idiot to actually know if the visual lag isn't going to kill me, because all of my deaths, or at least most of them so far, have been my own stupidity. Like that! That definitely qualifies as my own stupidity. So I'm going to stay right here. Play this one safe, and by safe I mean extremely dangerous. Like inches from lava, sprinting all the time, because why would you not sprint in this game? I mean, this is hyperspeed. I better be going fast or else it's not going to be fun. Gotta go fast. Gotta go faster, faster. Alright, hey, so that was easy now that there's no glitch. Excuse me, sorry. And that time it really was me. I swear, I did not edit this. And I already beat this level. I'm gonna skip ahead now. Alright, so last I saw, I was correct. The next world I have to do is the end. So hey, maybe I can even finish this today. That's a joke, guys. I'm clearly not going to. We're also not doing Cotton Alley, mind you. Maybe in the future we'll return to this, but for this series, at least for now, I'm gonna end it at the end. Oh, there's only six levels. Okay, that makes me feel so much better. And by better, I mean like 100 times worse. So far this seems pretty easy. I have a feeling I'm gonna eat those words. And drink my own blood. Oh, wait a second. Alright, I'm guessing I'm not supposed to be able to do that. Where the hell's the key? Oh, hello. You look like a key. Alright, this doesn't seem too hard. I mean, I'm not really speedrunning it, I'm playing it safe, but that's because this game is typically incredibly difficult, and I'd rather not die repeatedly. Motherfucker. I totally pressed jump, I just pressed it too late. That was not the glitch, don't worry. We're not having that issue again. Motherfucker. No, we're having completely different issues. Issues where I'm mentally fucking retarded. You know, mental impairment. I have a mental deficiency, and that deficiency is an inability to beat this game, no matter what happens. So, naturally, that's what's gonna happen. Here we go. Let's try and do this carefully. I'm not gonna be quick about it. I know I'm supposed to be speedrunning it, technically, but let's be honest, I'm not a professional speedrunner or a professional gamer in any way. I'm actually thoroughly terrible at games, and that's what makes this so damn hard for me, and so damn amusing for you. So I hope you appreciate my pain. Because I'm doing this for you people. I'm actually quite worn out. It's, oh. I actually thought I was gonna... Never mind. I was gonna say I thought I was gonna die, but then, you know what? I actually did die, so... I thought right, apparently. I just thought too soon. I was ahead of the curve. I'm clearly so brilliant. I was able to predict the future that I was going to die. You know what? I'm gonna predict the future again. I bet you on the next level I'm gonna die like 1,000 more times than I do here, because so far this one's not that hard. God damn it! I say as I die to the easiest freaking obstacle in the game, freaking regular buzzsaw, like it's nothing. Oh, you know what? I can just fall. I forgot I can just fall on that one. Here we go. Hup. 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 There we go. Alright, this shouldn't be too hard now. It's just one more section of this. God damn it! I'm seriously bad at this, guys. God damn it. Sorry, that was my really crappy attempt to actually speedrun it this time. And I think I'm gonna start actually trying to go fast and efficiently through these levels, but We'll see how well that actually goes. I'm currently holding down the sprint button continually, so that's that means something, right? Oh, what the hell? I didn't unlock that? What did I do? Did I just forget to get the one on the left again? I probably did. Bet you I can... No, I can't. I was hoping maybe I could jump up there and just go straight for it. That would be convenient and kind of funny, because everyone's probably gonna... If that were the case, that you could just do that, everyone would probably do it the correct way, and then the game would be like, haha, you're all idiots for doing it the correct way, because it's easy. But no, that's not the case. Actually, that's impossible. What I was trying to do was physically impossible. Alright, let's hope. God damn it. Let's try not to lose all hope, right? That's what I should say, because my only hope right now is that maybe, just maybe, I won't die of a freaking caffeine overdose from this stuff. That is the only thing I can hope for. That is probably more than I can hope for, but I like to be optimistic. I like to think that maybe, just maybe, everything's gonna be alright. Alright, so it looks like I did open that door now. Yeah, okay, I did, definitely. I didn't want to go up there if it wasn't up open. No. Okay, there we go. Alright, this part looks pretty simple. I just gotta time it. There we go. Ayo! Beat the first level of the end. Look out, Dr. Fetus, I'm coming for you. You sorry ass piece of crap. I am coming for you. You know it. I have no idea what I'm doing right now. I'm just kind of following what appears to be the natural flow of this level. I don't actually know where I'm going at all. Oh, wait a second. Maybe if I stop sprinting like an idiot, I can actually figure out what the hell I'm supposed to be doing for once. God damn it. Well, at least I didn't die. Here we go. Satellite. Radio. Here we go. That's it. Right there. Oh, god damn it. Nope. Oh, right there! God frickin' damn it. Hey! God damn it. Alright, so basically, this appears to be, I just have to go through this, and then back through this. Shouldn't be too hard, right? I say as I get not even as far as I did last time. Luckily, that part you can kind of just drop right through. That's a nice little relaxing moment of just dropping. Just doing whatever floats your boat. Whatever floats your goat. Whatever fucks your goat. Whatever that's all she wrote. Whatever crocodiles in a moat. Whatever, man. God fucking damn it. I had it too. I was right freaking there, and I was just like, you know what? I don't feel like winning today. Nope. Don't feel like it. I feel like taking like 50 more tries to do this because, I mean, I could end it right here, but no. I'm gonna fall in a pit instead. I do remember particularly that the last level of this game was 10 times harder than anything else I've ever seen, so. That's something to look forward to, right? Oh, god damn it. Look at me, being optimistic, thinking maybe, just maybe, I can make it right through there on the first try, but nope. Why would that happen? Nope, I have to be ready for failure. I have to be prepared for it. That's why I have, like, 7 cases of this stuff. This, energy drink. You know, I'm pretty sure, actually, that panel that I'm jumping to there is actually a red herring, and I'm actually supposed to actually not say actually so many actually times. I'm pretty sure that panel is a red herring, and I'm supposed to go straight to death. Straight to death. It's the most efficient way to end this. Most efficient way to make it to the finale. The finale is my death. It's the canonical end of this game, is that I just die, and that's what happens. And then it's over. It's all over. Okay. Yes, I made it. Okay, now let's not screw this up because I'm not sure I'm going to be able to make that jump ever again. Pretty sure that was sheer luck. Oh no, I screwed it up. Just like I said, I probably would. Naturally. Let's not do this thing that I'm currently doing at the moment as I say this. You might be able to tell that I'm starting to get a little bit more hyper as my speech gets faster, but currently I'm still able to at least think straight, which is more than I can usually do. I'm out. This one's out. I'm out of stuff for this one. I'm gonna finish this level, and then potentially... Well, okay. Okay. Alright. I didn't think that was gonna happen. Didn't think I was gonna make it straight through on the first go. I was not ready for it. Heyo! Did it. No, I didn't. Okay. So, been on this level for a while. Oh, right. I'm gonna at least finish this level before I open another can. But, don't rest assured, I will be opening another can. And I will probably be finishing it, and potentially opening another. I think my rule of thumb should be, I am allowed to finish the level I'm on before opening another can, in all cases. Like, whenever I finish a can, I'm gonna complete that level before I go opening another one. My crash is going to be rather quick now. You know, your caffeine crash, because this stuff is caffeine, and that makes you crash. So I'm gonna get tired and annoyed very quickly. And my crash is gonna happen fast if I don't drink it repeatedly. And I'm not used to the caffeine. I've been off it for a while, so it's probably gonna be a harsh crash. So we'll see how that goes. But we'll see that when we get there, right? Right, guys? Right? God damn it. Alright, I didn't die. It's fine. It's fine, guys. Everything's okay. It's not over yet. Alright, so I have to now figure out what I'm doing wrong here. I need to get back. I'm thinking maybe if I try to make it straight for that panel. Oh, okay. Actually, I'm pretty sure if I just hold to the right, I might be able to land on that panel, so let's try that this time. God damn it. Or, you know, let's try dying. Dying prematurely. I'm sure that's the solution to this. Of course. Death. Death is always the solution. That was a pretty messed up joke, but a worse one came into mind, so be thankful I didn't say the second one I thought of. So you may have noticed I'm looking, like, way up at the screen this time, more so than usual. Sorry about that. Unfortunately, the reason why is because, god fucking damn it. Unfortunately, the reason why is because I have this set up at a different location, which you probably also noticed from the backdrop that I am not in my usual hyperspeed location. Rather, I'm in our studio that we use for everything else. All of our regular shows and our streams. This is where we usually do that. So, not in my usual hyperspeed location. I don't know why I did that. I don't know why I did that. I don't know why I do half the shit I do. You know, sometimes I just don't know. Sometimes I don't know so hard that I don't even know what I don't know. That's how hard I don't know. I'll don't know you so hard. Alright, here we go. There we go. Alright, we're gonna head right this time. Oh, wait. I actually made it that time. Now, how do we get back? Because it was pretty easy getting here. But I have a feeling it's not gonna be that easy to get back. God damn it, why did I do that? Why did I do that? What possessed me to do that? Just kinda like, jump off the side. My brain was like, Blake, jump off the fucking side. Stupid twat. And then I did. Because usually my brain is right. Not this time. No. God damn it, brain, you led me astray. Okay. Ah! I knew that was coming. I saw it from a mile away. It was like, again, my brain just straight up told me to do that. And that's why I saw it coming so hard. I was like, coming so hard. Shut up. I know what you're thinking. You have a dirty mind. God damn it. Come on, just go in the thing. It shouldn't be that hard. Just go in the thing, please. Thank you. No! Okay. This time I'm just gonna hold to the right. Or the left, I mean. I don't even know which direction is left and right anymore. Because I'm pretty sure if I hold to the left, either I'm gonna go into that enclosed area where I'm safe, or I'm gonna fall on the panel down below where I'm safe, so hopefully that's my plan. Let's be honest, there's no making plans with Meat Boy. He does whatever he wants. Like that. I'm gonna blame that on him, totally not me. I didn't do that. I didn't just run off that cliff like a freaking idiot. No, why would I do that? I mean, what do you think I am? Some kind of dunce? I think I got a dunce cap? You think they put me in the corner at school? In a white cone on my head? No. No. The cone that was on my head was actually pink. They wanted to humiliate me even more. Heyo, so yeah, the left thing worked. So now the question is, how do I make it there? And the answer is easily, apparently. Okay, let's not do anything dumb. Now I know why that's there. Heyo, we are back. This part should be easy. Right. Okay, I'm safe. I did it! Alright, cool. We're through that level, so let's open another can. And I'll probably only consume two of them today. And hopefully I'll finish this entire series today, but that's not gonna happen. The last level alone is gonna take me like 5 episodes. Just look at how many tries this took me. I don't mind taking a couple sips for all those tries that I did there without sipping. Look at that. Just look at that. How ridiculous that is. Look at all the ways that I failed. Ha! Yup. There's my failures. So you may notice I'm wearing pajamas. That's because I'm on spring break. And, spring break's a nice thing to be on. Unlike meth. Meth is not a nice thing to be on. This looks easy. Why is this in the end? This looks easy. I mean, as long as there's no moving panel glitches. This is... It's easy, man. It's easy. No problem. Not a difficult at all. Nah. No, actually, this is legitimately easy compared to what I've dealt with in the past. This may even be easier than hell, to be honest. Hell wasn't even that hard. If I wasn't holding sprint that one time that I screwed that up, I would have been fine. Right, this looks a little bit more challenging, but I think I can do it. I'm just going to wait till that one passes. And then drop down here. And hello! Huh, okay. So, that opened something, but it wasn't what I needed to open. The question is, what was it? And the answer is, it opened me. It opened me. With a blade, in fact. Oh, I see. I have to pick up the things that are in each of these. Okay. I'm pretty sure, first of all, I need to take like 2 sips. I'll just take a big swallow on that one. I'm pretty sure if I move in the direction of the blades, it'll be a lot easier. So let's try that. Oops. Okay. Yes, okay. So that's not too hard. If I move in the direction of the blades, I should be safe. Oops. Yes, okay. Yep, okay. So that's not too hard, actually. If I could not die, then it would definitely be a lot easier. If I would just not die. I mean, how hard can it be to just not frickin' die? Right? Am I right, guys? Not dying should be easy. But no, it's not. It's never easy. It's never that easy. But this one I feel like I've done on separate different tries everything I needed to beat this one. I'm pretty sure it won't be that hard to finish it off, to be honest. Hope you enjoyed that burp. please, play a replay of that burp, super fast and super slow. Motherfucker. I actually didn't think that was gonna get me there, to be honest. I don't know why. It was pretty obvious it was going to. I guess I was just a terrible judge of distance, that's all. Okay, here we go. Yes. Okay, let's not do anything stupid, first of all, like I just almost did. Heyo. And I'm through. Now if I can just stay right on the edge here, hop up, land there. All right, yeah, this is going well. Right on the thing. All right, we can make a little hop here and then go with this one down and below. Hey, we're almost there. Look at that. I just have to not do anything freaking stupid here, like totally idiotic. Heyo, look what I did. Hey, I succeeded, and I almost took a drink just out of habit. Because I habitually die. Now this is, startlingly easy compared to the rest of the game, actually. I mean, obviously each level's taken me a couple tries, but once I figure out what I'm doing, it's been harder. There's definitely been harder levels than these. This one seems a bit difficult. The, saw rotating counter to my direction is a little bit annoying, I'll be honest. But, I don't think it's gonna kill me too much. Look at that. Okay, let's see what we got here. We got a couple saws moving counter to my direction. Oh no, that one's moving with my direction once I get up there. Okay, so, standing on the top of this thing, I am safe. Never mind, I'm not on the top of that thing anymore, so I'm not safe. Heyo. Alright, saws. Easy enough. These ones, I just gotta go in the middle. Yes. I'm doing some Mission Impossible here. Some Mission Slightly Difficult here, because it's actually startlingly easy. To the point where it scares me, actually. It concerns me how easy this is, because I have a feeling they're doing this to screw with me. To lull me into a false sense of security before I go into the end. The actual end. They're making it seem like it's gonna be no problem at all. And then it's just going to kill me 1,000 times in a row. Okay, well, I don't know why I did that, but I don't know why I did that either. Alright, so let's blast through these levels. These ones, not even hard, man. Meat Boy, don't you got more for me than this? This is pathetic, man. Actually, I don't know how to do this one. God damn it. Well, I'll tell you what. For certain, that is not the solution. That saw right there at the bottom is positioned in the most inconvenient place. It's not hard to get around. It just makes me stop when I don't want to. Just makes me stop here and wait. Just a minor inconvenience at worst. I have yet to be killed by it, but I'm sure that's gonna change. After 1,000 tries, I'll probably die on literally everything you can possibly die on. I'll probably die on the ground. Like, not the ground as in from falling from a height. I mean, like, the ground as in, like, the standard ground that you're supposed to stand on. I'm sure somehow that will kill me, because that's just how this game rolls. You know, I mean, like I said in previous episodes, if you can see it, it will kill you. If you can't see it, it'll kill you quicker because you won't know it's there. All right, speed this up a little bit. I'm gonna sing you guys a ballad, of rebirth and life and death.
Walking into a dream, so elaborate it seems. Shit, I don't remember the words. Fuck me then, right? Can't keep this fed up so I can blast through it. God damn it. This one's just annoying, man. I think it's intentionally designed such that it isn't hard. It just makes you stop. It breaks your flow at every turn, and it's very annoying. There's no consistent motion to it. I cannot make that jump on its own. Yeah, that's what I gotta do. Alright, so let's not die. That would be the first goal. This is quite annoying right here. Motor thunder. No saws there. I don't know how to get around them. Crap. I have to pee pretty bad, but mainly from drinking 2 cans of Bing Lanzer juice. Does tend to make you need to use the bathroom. You probably need a toilet. So I'm gonna go do that. And rather than cutting that out, I'm just going to speed it up and at the same time play the Jeopardy theme. So
alright, I have returned. This is the empty one. Just to make this a minor annoyance, unless I say otherwise, make the rest of this episode exactly 1.25 times speed.
Just cuz. God fucking damn it. Alright. Okay, I'm being a freaking idiot. Okay, I finally did it! Hey! Alright, everyone out there who had money on me hitting that saw, you better get twice your money back. Actually, three times, because I hit the saw a second time in a row like a freaking idiot. So if you were putting money on that, congratulations, you won the jackpot. Hopefully you can live your life in richness and, it's the opposite of poverty. It's not richness. Richness isn't a word, I'm pretty sure. Luxury, I suppose. Hopefully you can live the rest of your life in luxury, knowing that, you won a $5 bet. And that, you can buy yourself a soda. Or two. At your local, shopping mart. Your local Stop and Shop. Your local, can I run into that one? I cannot! I was really hoping I'd be able to just run straight into that one and just, you know, do the classic drop without pressing any jump button and make it right in there easy. I was hoping it was a trick and that it was actually easy. But why would I ever think that? Why would I ever think they would make anything in Super Meat Boy easy? It's living hell. It literally has a level, which is hell. Not even a level, a whole world of it is hell. And it's not even the last world. It's not even the hardest one. Like, you get through hell, and it's like, oh, here's 50,000 more levels of hell. It's like this entire game is different rings of hell. What are they called, rings? Is that what they are? You know, like Dante's Inferno thing? There's different levels of hell, and like, one of them happens to be what we know as hell, the fiery place, you know? And the rest of them are the other levels of this game. Because, god damn it. Alright, so, I was pretty close. If I'd held the jump button a bit longer, I would have made it through that, so I'm pretty sure I at least understand now what I'm supposed to be doing there. So, I can at least do that, at the very least. I know how to do it now. I might not pull it off on the first go, or the second go, or the 300th go, but at least I know what I'm supposed to do now, so let's try that. Hey, I did it! Alright, let's try not to do anything stupid now. I don't know what I'm supposed to do here, but there's a safe place for me to stand down there, so... Motherfucker! Oh, it's safe to stand here! Yuck! Freaking goofy, dude. God damn it. Alright, here we go. Let's not do anything completely idiotic like I just did. Because I'm a moron. I'm just always a moron. I'm a Mormon. It's a Mormon who's also really stupid. I'm actually not a Mormon, by the way. But I am a moron, so... Just for clarity's sake. In case you were wondering. I would like to officially state that I am not a Mormon, but I am a moron. Same thing, right? Actually, not same thing, and I don't mean to offend any Mormons out there. It's just a pun. It's called a pun. I know there are some people out there, not to point any fingers, Wall Street Journal. There are some people out there who can't, not to name any names, but Wall Street Journal. There's a lot of people out there who can't Wall Street Journal take a joke. So I just want to be clear that I don't mean any offense to Mormons. Just because their name sounds like moron does not make them morons. Just because dessert and desert are spelled the same way does not mean they are anything alike. For example, ice cream is a dessert, and it's very cold, and it's very pleasant. And the desert is the exact opposite. So if anything, what I'm saying is Mormons are geniuses. Despite the fact that I know essentially nothing about the Mormon faith. You know, strangely enough, I've actually never had anyone offer to tell me about it. Write down in the comments. If you're a Mormon, please write in the comments what your faith is based on. Tell me what you believe in. Because there's actually never been a Mormon come to my door. Someone came to my door once, but I don't think it was Mormons. It might have been Catholics. Do Catholics come to doors? Do Catholics do that thing? Someone did. I don't know. Might have been someone else. It was, I don't know. What else is there? It wasn't a Protestant, I know that. It had to be... It was definitely a Christian faith. It was a, I don't know. Do Mormons count as Christians? It was one of those, anyway. The, whole Jesus thing. The, you know. One of those things. One of the many variations on that. Wasn't a Mormon. It might have been. I don't think so. Was, What's the other one? What's the other one that goes to doors? There's definitely another one that goes to doors. At least one more. Mormons are not the only one, I swear. I don't know, man. Yeah, these levels are not making me nearly as infuriated as, okay, well, that pissed me off a bit, but... Nowhere near the level I was at with hell. I don't know, maybe it's just because I'm more focused. Maybe it's because I'm not entirely, energized yet. I'm not entirely, over the top. Speaking of over the top. Went right over it. Motherfucker. I just sworn I was doing that right, but nope. I just went right into that thing that is the obvious thing I'm not supposed to hit that I've mentioned a few times. Yeah. So I'm leaning excessively far forward, and I hope it doesn't look stupid. I feel like I have to for this mic. I probably don't. I can probably lean back. Hey, boost up my audio a bit. No, that's too much. God damn it. All right, put it back down. Thanks. That's about right. No, now it's too quiet. Put it back up. Louder. All right, cool. We're good. That's good. Stop it there. Close enough.
See, just part up from the moment I stopped saying that last thing I said. Just speed it up, so you don't have to endure the torture of me saying nothing. Okay, let's see. Yep.
Motherfuck. Okay. That's fine. This is fine. It's okay. I'm fine. There's nothing wrong with me. You know I'm not fine when I start to insist that I am fine. That's just like, it's the first telltale sign that I'm not fine. I might as well have just died there, because I ended up at the beginning anyway, so what does it matter? You know? What does any of this matter? What is life? What matters? What matters in life? I don't know. What's the meaning of life? I've been doing this for too long when I start to question the meaning of life. Is this the meaning of life? Was life created so that Meat Boy can have people to play it? Meat Boy is God, and everything was created in his image. Except most of us have skin too, and bones. But we also have meat. So, yep. Whoo! I like these heavenly rays from the right side here. I don't know why I just jumped over that, because I'm a freaking idiot apparently. But yeah, I like these heavenly rays. They make me feel so much better about my life. That's for certain. Bothers me though that for whatever reason that saw is the one thing in the world that doesn't shadow them. I guess saws are not. I guess saws don't have shadows in this universe. You know, I guess they're What doesn't have a shadow? Vampires don't have a reflection. Do vampires have a shadow? Somebody write in the comments whether or not vampires have a shadow. If you're a Mormon, please write in the comments whether or not vampires have a shadow. I don't know, I feel like directing more questions towards Mormons today. How are you guys doing? Not all of you, just the Mormons. Are you guys alright? Are you, you feeling alright? Feeling happy? Do you have a second to, hear about our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ? That's Mormons, right? Am I getting that wrong? Is that someone else? I don't know. I don't know who it is that says that all the time. God damn it. I need to stop doing that. Because I have a feeling it's going to get a lot easier once I complete that one section. It's just that one section is just... I'm being stupid. It's not even hard. It's just that I'm being stupid. The part that I've already completed multiple times is way harder than that. And that part that I'm referring to is this right here. This right here. There's way more in my way than there is in that other section. And yet somehow it's on that other section that I continually die. God damn it. God damn it. Well, I'm right back at the beginning. Just kill me. Just kill me. Thank you. I appreciate it. That's what I asked for. I don't belong here, I'm not moving on, dear. Escape from this afterlife, cause it's time I'm right to move on and on, far away from here. I would like to move far away from here. And by far away from here, I mean far away from Meat Boy. I would really like it if I was not anywhere in the vicinity of the existence of Meat Boy. If I could just not. If I could just not Meat Boy, that would be nice. I just... God damn it. Kill me now. Actually, please don't. I would really like to live this on this go. I would really like it if this particular iteration of Meat Boy would be the one that would save his girlfriend. That's all I want. All I want in the world is to save my girlfriend. I don't know why that has to be such an impossible task. I don't know why this particular fetus has some strong resentment for me. I don't know why he, on this particular day, decided to kill everything that belongs to me. Maybe he's getting revenge. I don't know. Maybe Meat Boy stuck his meat in Bandage Girl, and Bandage Girl had to get an abortion, and now the fetus is back from the dead to get revenge. I don't know. Maybe Meat Boy and Bandage Girl, like, they weren't ready for that commitment, maybe they didn't have the money to take care of a kid, and so they were like, I don't want to do this, but I can't. Like, maybe they thought it was better. I'm not saying that I agree, but maybe they thought it was better not to subject a child to a life of poverty than to And they just decided that death was better. And so, frickin' the fetus comes back. This is a really messed up narrative. But let's be honest, this game's pretty messed up. Why did I do that? Why in a million years did I do that? Also, why is it taking me so long to beat this part now? This part I've done a million times. It's gotten to the point where it's like second nature. You know, like, weep, whoop, oh wow, that thing that I thought was impossible earlier. Look, it's so easy. That part, but I just, god damn it. I don't know, man. I just don't know. Sometimes, you know, I just don't know. You know? Hey, so that, I don't know if you guys have heard, but Samurai Jack is, like, back, apparently. Which I am totally on board with, because Samurai Jack was awesome. When I watched it when I was a kid, it was awesome. And it was always, you know, it was violent for a kid's show, but they didn't show any blood, so it wasn't like bad, you know? It didn't have to be on an Adult Swim, it was considered a kid's show. And now, they put it back and it's on Adult Swim, and there's blood in it, and it's pretty cool, actually. It's, I like the seriousness of it. I need to stop killing myself. I need to focus. Focus. Yeah, when I get back to that part, I'm gonna stop talking. I'm just gonna, like... excuse me, sorry. Without any explanation, I'm just gonna stop talking when I get back to that section. Yippity-doo-dah, yippity-day. My oh my, what a wonderful day. No. God damn it. Okay, that's fine. This is fine, man. It's all good. All good, we're all fine. I like to point out that I've completed, I think this is the third level of the end, and I've already completely decimated my beverage. Two of them. Two energy drinks are already gone. Cause screw it, right? Why? Why though? But why? Can we get why though on screen? With like why the letter? Thank you for that. When I said it, I mean, not now, but thanks for putting it now anyway. Goddamn. Yee! Wow, that was really close. Alright, so, now. I wonder if I can just run off the top of here. Probably not. I'm not gonna take that chance. I'm gonna do this time. Short jump. Yes. Okay. I'm gonna think this through. And then, clearly, the risk was calculated, but man, am I bad at math. Clearly, I did not think that through, despite what I said. I was like, I can do this. This is fine. It's easy. It's easy. And man, was I wrong. It's not easy. This suddenly gotten way harder than it was. I mean, those first, like, two levels were, I mean, they were a challenge, right? They made me think. They made me act. But they were a cakewalk compared to this bullshit. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying, bruh? You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm super saying? I'm beyond saying, man. I've gone beyond the level of Saiyan. I'm Super Saiyan now. Okay, let's see. I think there might be an easier way to do this one. No! Apparently not. Apparently it's still not easy enough. I thought maybe if I landed on that platform down below, I could get a good angle on the jump there and make it. But no. Why would anything be... Why would there be an easier way to do anything in this game? Okay, okay. Yeah, this is what I'm trying to do, right? So if I'm on this platform, and I do a short jump there, I can... Yeah, I can make it. Alright, so from now on I can do that, and it makes it a little bit easier for me. That, though, was my own stupidity. And will continue to be my own stupidity. Because, screw me. With a rake. I don't know why a rake. Not the monster either, that would be weird. No, I mean like a garden rake. You know what I mean. Short jump, and I'm over. Alright, so, that part is easy now, right? Right? Easy. Now what I need to do is figure out how to not be a freaking idiot. And that is not easy. Because my specialty, right, is being an idiot. My freaking specialty. I am a professional idiot, quite frankly. I'm paid to be an idiot. That's not entirely true, actually. I don't get paid for this. But, if you want to make a donation, my PayPal is linked below. I'm kidding. I'm not linking my PayPal to this. God damn it. God fucking damn it. Alright, give me some more Jeopardy music. I'm gonna go to the bathroom. Holy crap, do I have a pain in my side right now. Probably from all the energy drinks. I should probably stop. At least temporarily. You know, maybe it's not good to be drinking 3 cans of expired Bing juice. You know, maybe that's not exactly good for my health. I don't know why I did that. You know, I just really wanted to practice this section again. You know, I just really felt I needed it. I felt like this was the part that I wasn't sure I would be able to beat again. So I just wanted to test it, right? You know, just to be sure, just to be absolutely certain. Cause who knows? All right, so, yep, just testing it. I mean, come on, man. What do you think I did that by accident? I just like showing off this part, you know? Because I know I can do this part. So I just like to show off my awesome jump skills right here. On that part right there, see? I like to tease that saw a bit. Give it a little strip tease. As it strips my skin from my body. Because I'm so freaking close to it that it touches me. And freaking rips it off. But no, I don't die. No, I just live in endless agony. Why would I die? No, of course. I live in agony for my whole life. Alright, so what I thought, right? Is... That part I found an easier way to do by going on the wall, right? So maybe if I go on the wall on this one and do a short jump the same way. Nope, short jump doesn't work. Okay. Good to know. Let's try a longer jump on that one then. Let's try and do that one the correct way now. The short jump seems to be a helpful little tool. But it is not an Omni tool. It is not helpful in all cases. What is an Omni tool anyway? That's from something. That's definitely a reference to something. Put up the text, some text telling you what that's a reference to. Just put up the title of whatever that's a reference to. Omni tool, please. Let's get some Omni tools on screen. Thank you. Okay, now I gotta jump carefully down and not kill myself, which apparently is too much for me. The jumping down part, no, I can do that, no problem. But without killing myself, no, that's. That's where I draw the line. I'm sorry. I just like killing myself too much. I'm too into it. You know, I'm too obsessed. I really like death, man. I really like it. It just makes me so happy. You see this big smile on my face? These big teeth grin right here, you see? Yeah, that's from how happy this makes me. Whoo! Slipping from happiness to anger to depression in one sentence. Yeah, that's just great. This is what this game does to me. It's an emotional gauntlet. It's a physical and emotional gauntlet. It's an emotional gauntlet filled with emotional saws. And those saws just chop me up into little tiny broken pieces, and I just can't handle it. You know, I just can't deal. And I don't really like the phrase "can't deal." It's not really my thing. I don't typically use it. But this is something I certainly cannot deal with. It's too much, man. Like freaking the guy. What's the name of that guy? I think he's bald. He hosted that game show. He just comes on here and he's like, "Deal or no deal?" And I'm like, "No deal, man. I can't deal. It's impossible. I'm incapable of dealing, personally. I don't know why I didn't even attempt the short jump there. I know it's easier. I know the short jump is easier on that one. Why didn't I try it? Who knows? Who knows? My mind is a mystery. My lack of intelligence is its own mystery. And if you can solve it, then you are a better man than I. Sorry, I looked away for a second because my mouse fell down and I wanted to make sure it didn't click anything and stop the recording or anything. But it didn't, so we're all good. Most likely, this episode's gonna be a long one, and it's gonna be me getting to the last level of the end, and then the next episode will be me playing the last level of the end, and hopefully I can beat it in one episode. But that's a bit optimistic, considering how hard this is. Heyo, I'm in. Alright, so this one, those saws are just positioned just the right distance that make them really, really hard to dodge. And don't mind me, that's a new world record, twice in a row, for shortest possible death in Meat Boy. Like, immediate death. Immediate! I was going for a record on that one, man. It's a speed running record. Fastest death. Fastest death. Yep. I'm going for the world record of most deaths on the end. I don't know, I think I can do it. I think I might be capable of beating the world record for worst frickin' Super Meat Boy player of all time. I don't mean to brag, you know? I don't want to toot my own horn. I did enough of that last night, to some really lewd, fuck, I don't even know. I was trying to think of something that's weird to jack off to, but not weird enough that's like, whoa, man, are you serious? But man, I just couldn't. Everything is either normal or weird. There's like no in between, you know? You can't just be like, oh, midget porn. Midget porn is the right level of weird. That's what I was going for, yep. Because midget porn is something generally agreed upon to be weird, but joked about enough that no one's gonna think I'm serious. There you go. But little do you know that I'm actually... No, I'm kidding. I'm not into midgets. I don't want to go that far. I don't want to go that far with this joke. I mean, no offense to short people. I mean, I'm sure you're very nice people. I'm just not personally attracted to you. Simply by your height. I'm not someone who judges my level of attractiveness primarily off of height. Therefore, I am not automatically into short people. Although sometimes short girls can be kind of cute. You know. You know. I mean, I'm kind of a short guy, so. Kind of fits my size, right? You know? And. Motherfucker. I was so close. You know? Yeah, also, please speed up that section right up until right before I died. So, because. Motherfucker. Alright, so I'm pretty sure that if on that one, once I grab that key, and leave this part in, I wanna say this part. I'm pretty sure that on that one, once I grab that key, I can touch the wall, like the edge of the platform I'm standing on, right? And then I'm pretty sure if I am located there, I can drop straight. So that's gonna be my goal on that one, is to... What just happened? Can I seriously do that? Is that a thing I can do? I'm gonna try that, actually. Because that'll make that part significantly easier if I can just do that. But yeah, I'm pretty sure if I touch that wall and then just drop... God damn it! I am seriously stupid. I'm seriously lacking in intelligence. I'm lacking in brain area capacity and... I'm also starting to lack in frickin' patience. Like, I'm a patient person, right? I'm pretty patient. That's why usually... Rage games don't get to me all that much. It takes a lot to get to me. And usually... But this game, man, it gets to me. Because it's just death after death. It's a rage game on its own. Plus, drinking tons of caffeine does not help. When I'm energied up, I can get kind of... I can get a little bit frustrated, you know? You can usually tell when I'm frustrated, too, by my high-pitched voice. It suddenly... Something goes like this. That just sounds just a little bit insane. But yeah. This game frustrates me. A little bit, just a tiny bit, you know. How did I do that last time? I landed right here, and then did it. I don't know. I'm not even gonna try it because I just want to beat this level. I don't even care how I do it, as long as I beat this level. There we go. All right. So what I'm gonna try here is if I can. There we go. Oh nope. Okay, that's not the solution. All right. Whatever. I'm not gonna do it then. All right. So I was hoping that if I was just right there, if I happened to be just right there, I might make it through all of them. But nah. Nah. Nah, why would they ever make it so that you can drop in a particular location? You know? I mean, come on, guys. Getting to that particular spot is hard enough. You think you can at least give me that? Like, just give me an easy pass if I can get to that particular, very specific location, you know? Like, maybe I could just get a pass for this, but no. Alright, so what I want to do here is drop, and then right into the saw. Don't even try to avoid the saw. Just drop right into it. Straight into it. Come on, man. Screw it, man. I figured I might as well go back to the start and then kill myself. Don't bother killing myself there. And don't bother just going back to the start and then trying again. I had to do both. I had to go back to the start and kill myself. Why did I do that? Why'd I do that? Who knows? Who frickin' knows, man? I am an enigma. Alright, speed this part up again. Who created this game? Please, somebody send me the name of the guy who created this game. I just want to know when the Antichrist shows up that it's him, you know? Like, if it's not obvious enough to begin with, who the Antichrist is, like, when I hear the name of this guy and it's like, he's back from the dead! He's a great and powerful being, it's the return of Christ, I'm gonna be like, nope, no man, that's the Antichrist, clearly. It's obvious. Because this man must be the Antichrist. God damn it. I'm very surprised at how many tries it's taking me now just to make it to that part, just so I can die again. Just, the challenge is just to see how many times I can die on that particular saw, because clearly the challenge is not to get past that saw, because that's never gonna happen. I mean, let's set realistic goals here.
Yeah. Why did I do that?
I really didn't think I was gonna make that jump, so I just kinda like flipped out. Why did I do that? Kill me now, just kill me now. Fucking end it. Just fucking end it. I don't even care.